Good evening. In a major backdown, the state government has agreed to lifelong support for police officers who are seriously injured on the job. But now the dispute's been settled, 7 News can reveal other emergency service workers will push for the same deal.
Comfort at last for officers who've copped lifelong injuries on the job.
There are a lot of tears after I found out, a lot of high fives. But that's just because of the sheer relief of knowing that we have that security in the remainder of our careers.
This has been a tense time for all of our families and all the police members that were affected by this legislation.
4,600 sworn officers now know their medical bills and wages will be paid if they're injured on active duty, even beyond the 2-year cut-off for all other workers.
When everyone else is running out of the building, we're running in. And so it was that unique nature and that call to duty that needed to be covered.
The government will reinstate the rights through employment deals, not legislation.
They're only fixing a mess they created themselves.
The move will cost taxpayers $2.2 million a year, but politically it's a small price to pay to stop a fight with a powerful union.
This could have been a game changer at the next election. This is a huge backflip that had to occur.
The backflips may continue. Nurses say they'll fight for the same deal.
Their work is inherently risky, and therefore we believe that coverage should extend to include the nursing midwifery professions.
And 7 News understands prison officers, fireys and ambos will also request talks.
And if they have reasonable requests and good arguments, we'll assess those on their merits throughout the enterprise bargaining process.
Jane Stinson, 7 News.